Final Four action this weekend, both the women's and the men's tournament. Exciting times all the way around, but we are going to keep you updated on the latest odds here at the FanDuel Sports Book on how you can get down on some certain wagers this weekend for the Final Four and, of course, Monday's championship game. Now, if we're looking for epic results, Joe Ranieri, in that game, we're probably hoping it's going to be Purdue versus UConn. But let's set the table for that. Winning the national championship at the FanDuel Sportsbook, Connecticut comes in as the favorite right now to minus 185 price. Purdue plus 190. Alabama at a 13-1 price. And NC State at 20-1. So I'm going to ask you this question first. These numbers haven't shifted around all that much. But do you agree Connecticut should be the heavy favorite to cut down the nets and win the national championship?
Absolutely. I don't think there's a better team on that list there. And you may think you're going to get some value by trying to go against it. But again, value only works if that team can actually win the game, and they can't. So I do think that at 185 right now, and I think we said the look-ahead lines was, what, 5, 5.5, I think, somewhere in that ballpark, if it is the number ones, Purdue versus UConn. I am fairly confident that one side will be UConn. I do think NC State will make it interesting here, but ultimately, talent is going to win out, and UConn and Purdue have the most of it, and that's usually how it works when it comes to the March Madness and a national championship.
Now, you see UConn at a minus 185 price to win it all. If you take a look at Connecticut versus the field, which means you can pick Connecticut to win the national championship, or you can pick Purdue, Alabama, and or NC State. Now, the price points here for that taking the field aren't going to be as good as, let's just say, if you took Alabama and they win it at 13-1, you'd only cash in that ticket at a plus 146. If you were betting this strategy, and let's just say you had to do it here, going Connecticut versus the field, would it be Connecticut at a minus 184 price for you, Joe? Or would you say to yourself, I'd rather bet Purdue, Alabama, and NC State all together, or those three teams individually with the higher price points, because maybe you have a feel that NC State can pull the upset, Alabama and or Purdue? Which way would you go with that wager?
Well, I think both teams, both favorites are favorites for a reason, and big favorites in that part. So I would only look to go any sort of combination of UConn, Purdue, followed by UConn winning the national championship. I just think that's what this is going to play out as. This is usually how it goes, right, Donnie? I mean, if we're expecting, and by the way, Purdue's a one seed, so it's not like it's far-fetched here. Great runs by Bama and North Carolina State. I do think it's going to be one hell of a final with UConn and Purdue. But at the same time, I think the last opportunity to get any value is right now looking at maybe NC State getting the points against Purdue, because I don't think they're beating Purdue. But I do think UConn covers their number against Alabama. And it was 10.5 at the open. It's now 11.5. And it would not shock me if this number starts to creep up closer to tip-off.
Yeah, sometimes we do get those high spreads on one of those games in the Final Four, Joe, but it's very rare that we're basically looking at two teams and two games in the Final Four here that are close to double digits, if not by game time, just might be both of them at double digits. We'll see how it plays out, but upsets certainly always can happen, and we have to remind ourselves it's the Final Four. It is a football stadium. Yep. It is in Arizona. No real home court advantage for any one of these ball clubs, and we'll see how it plays out, which another market here has to deal with awards, and that's the Final Four's most outstanding player. Zach Edey comes in right now at a plus 195 price. Newton and Klingon follow at plus 340 each. The one thing we can assess that if Purdue wins the national championship, it won't be because what Braden Smith had, 60 points combined in the Final Four and the final games here. It's going to be Zach Edey was absolutely unstoppable, therefore the high price point here. But Newton and Klingon, obviously, along with UConn and Stephon Castle at 20-1, you're saying to yourself, and then also Cam Spencer at 5-1, a multitude of guys can win because they're such a deep team that anybody can go for 20 points on any given night. So betting Connecticut, yes, you're getting better prices, but there's no worse feeling in the world that you say, I'm going to bet Donovan Klingon to win MOP at plus 340 as opposed to just betting UConn to win the championship. Watch UConn cut down the nets and Tristan Newton takes home MOP. If you were betting this market here, which way would you be going for UConn, Purdue, and also Sears at Alabama if they win at a 20-1 price?
Yeah, they won't win. But Edey is interesting because I think he's the one guy on there. Well, let me ask you this. Is there any situation I can come up where because there's so many different guys on UConn, right? And any mm-hmm. one of them are capable of winning that award for, you know, for that game. But has Edie got enough goodwill now with people who vote on this, where if it's a close game and let's say, you know, they lose by a bucket, but Edie drops 30 on, is there any way he could lose the next game, the championship, but still win this award?
I don't think so. I just think it's prescribed there as the winning team.
Has it ever happened?
That award. I think they said it happened in 1983 with Akeem Olajuwon, I believe, won it when that year that NC State had that improbable Jim Valvano run. So I think there is precedent for it. But again, it's not as if it happened 4 years ago. It happened in 1983, 40 years ago, roughly. So we'll see if it happens. But you're right. There is an extenuating circumstance, but it just would feel odd. Mm. Like UConn wins the national championship. We're the best team all year. And it's like, oh, yeah, MOP is going to Edie. Like, that's why we have like the Naismith Award. Like, hey, look. Doesn't matter if you win this tournament here. You're the best college basketball player. Here's your award. It would be interesting if that Final Four, again, Edie could go for 35 points on Saturday and another 35 on Monday and score 70 total points. The next closest guy was, let's just say, clinging at 42 points. Then you would have an argument and possibly could happen. I just don't know if they would usurp the top champions here and not give them also the MOP award. But there is some fun betting markets here, Joe, on the FanDuel Sports Book. You can get down with if you're just not looking to take straight wagers. How about this? UConn to win both games by 10 or more points at a plus 215. You're saying to yourself, plus 10 or more points, you're crazy. Well, they're favored by 11 and a half in game number one. And if they do take on Purdue, it is 5.5. But if they take on somebody else, it will be double digits. That's not a bad way to look because, quite frankly, UConn smokes everybody outside of the Big East, it feels like.
I agree there. Now, I don't know what the third one is interesting, too, with the UConn men and women both winning the title.
Yeah.
And the women being in the Final Four there. I don't know what their odds are currently right now. But if I'm confident that UConn men are winning the title, then you just got to do some math to figure out if there's any value in that by including the UConn women here, but I don't know if they'll be how big of a dog or a favorite they would be if they eventually they win this first game there against Iowa and then move on. So that's an interesting one too, because I'm half of those parlays, I'm confident that UConn's winning it. Yes, I'm confident UConn's winning those games. I'm also confident they're covering the first game by more than 10 points, and then you got to figure, is it worth me? Because that's a pretty better price than what you would get, even if they were laying 5.5 against Purdue, and they would be the favorite against Purdue. What would that number be if it was North Carolina State, Donnie? How many are we talking crazy. UConn would be favored over NC State? The number would have to be astronomical.
Yeah, I think it was 15.5 is the look-alike. Yeah, exactly. Wow. We could wind up with an unbelievable Monday, or we could wind up with this looks like a snooze fest right here at this point. By the way, the women's tournament here, UConn is a 7-1 price right now to cut down the nets, and obviously they would have to beat Iowa to get into the final against South Carolina. But it's not a bad way to look because there might be some hedging opportunities because UConn is a very good women's basketball team. It's not going to be a obviously crazy surprise if they can knock off Iowa, which then probably would put you in the money. Because you're thinking that UConn is already going to cut down the nets regardless of who they play. Might be a fun scenario to let it play out, and certainly for a little bit bigger money there. But also, yes, the NC State men and the NC State women to win the national championship, both of them there, 272-1. So that is a monster ticket that certainly can be up there if you're willing to bet on those type of markets. But I'm sure some of these fun specials at the FanDuel Sports will continue throughout the week, and we'll certainly keep you updated if any of those lines changes. But right now, it looks like we are on a collision course for Monday night, and nobody's going to complain about the Purdue Boilermakers taking on the UConn Huskies for all the marbles here. And also, the women's Final Four Friday night and a championship game on Sunday. Love to see it, people. The Mouth in the South joins us next. Let's continue to hit the hardwood here, right here on the Early Line.